Dear students, today we will begin with next chapter, Magnetic Effects of Electric Current. In lower classes you were taught about magnetic forces. Magnetic force is the force of attraction or repulsion between two magnets or a magnet and a magnetic material body. Now, first we will discuss about the properties of magnet. There are several properties of magnet, but two properties are very important, and first property is attractive property. Attractive property means a magnet always attracts magnetic material. You must have noticed that a piece of magnet is capable to attract small iron nails or paper pins or iron filings. This property of magnet is termed as attractive property. Another very interesting property of the magnet is directive property. Directive property means a freely suspended magnet always settles itself in a north-south direction. Means if you suspend a magnet freely, then it will always set itself in the north-south direction. This property of magnet is called directive property. Now, magnetic effects of electric current. A scientist named Oersted performed a series of experiments and found that a current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet. Means, when current flows in a conductor, it becomes magnet. So, this is all about to be discussed in the chapter. First term, magnetic field. The region or space around a magnet in which its force can be experienced is called its magnetic field. Naturally, force will be experienced by another magnet or some magnetic material body. Suppose a magnet is kept over there and another magnet enters in its magnetic field. Then the magnet which enters will experience some force, maybe of attraction or repulsion. So that space up to which its force can be experienced is termed as magnetic field. Next term is magnetic field strength. The magnitude of magnetic field The value of the magnetic field is termed as magnetic field strength. It is a vector quantity. It means it has magnitude as well as direction. And its SI unit is Tesla. That is, the SI unit of magnetic field strength is Tesla. Magnetic field strength is denoted by the symbol capital B. Another unit of magnetic field is Oersted. Now, there is a question. Suppose a bar magnet is brought near to the compass needle, or a compass needle is brought near to the bar magnet. What will happen? Compass needle it is a tiny magnet, and suppose it is moved towards a bar magnet. Bar magnet will have its own magnetic field, and if a compass needle is brought near to the bar magnet, it means it will enter into the magnetic field of bar magnet. As I told you, compass needle itself is a tiny magnet, so it will experience some force due to which it will get deflected. Another important term is magnetic field lines. They are also known as magnetic lines of force. Before I explain it, I will discuss here. Suppose this is a magnet, and suppose this is a bar magnet. This is north pole of the bar magnet, it is the south pole of the bar magnet. Now, a compass needle is placed over here. Then, compass needle is having a structure like this. Head and tail. Head always points towards north, and this always points towards south. Now, when magnetic line of force, compass needle will be placed near the bar magnet, naturally this north pole will attract the south end of the compass needle, and this north pole will be repelled, because like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other. So this will go, then again if we place here, south pole will be attracted, north pole will be repelled. What I want to say is that in the presence of magnetic field, the tiny magnet will align itself in a particular direction. North pole will follow certain path. So in a magnetic field, the path followed by the isolated north pole, isolated pole doesn't exist, but see, the path followed by the north pole is called magnetic field line or magnetic lines of force. Now, very simple to understand. the path followed by the North Pole in a magnetic field is called magnetic line of force. Why North Pole will follow a path? Because it is kept in the North Pole, means there is a magnet. Magnet will experience some force in the magnetic field because it has been kept in the magnetic field, and if it is free to move, then certainly it will move, and when it will move, it will follow certain path. So that path followed by the North Pole in a magnetic field is called magnetic line of force. Now, question is, what is the importance of magnetic line of force or magnetic field lines? Suppose a North Pole is moving like this, then at any point of the magnetic, this is the path followed by the North Pole, and therefore this is the magnetic field line. Then at any point of the magnetic line force, if we draw tangent means line touching at that point, will give us the direction of magnetic field at that point. So the importance of magnetic field line is to tell the direction of magnetic field. As I told you, magnetic field intensity is a vector quantity. It has direction also. So this is the way to determine the direction of magnetic field. Now we will draw the magnetic lines of force due to a bar magnet. This is a bar magnet, this is the North Pole of the bar magnet, and this is the South Pole of the bar magnet. Then magnetic line of force now, till now you will be finding the figure very simple, very easy to draw, but this figure has got two technical points on which your diagram will be assessed, evaluated. The two important things to be kept in mind while drawing the magnetic field lines due to a bar magnet are, first, the arrow must be marked from north to south direction. Reason I will tell you later on. All the magnetic lines, they emerge from North Pole. That means they are going away from the North Pole. So you will take care of marking the arrow. And they are emerging from North Pole and merging into South Pole. They are coming towards South Pole. So this is first technical points, and it is not that here towards north to south and this way. No, all the sea, north to south. Second thing which you will take care of, the relative distance between two magnetic lines of force. As you are moving away from the magnet, the relative distance between two lines of force must increase. it should be clearly visible in the diagram. You can see here also. See these two, this is the gap and this. If I will have to draw, suppose three I have drawn, fourth, then I will draw like this. So that the difference between next two should be larger than these two. So this is the magnetic field lines due to a bar magnet. Now, next point. Again, magnetic field lines are the path followed by the north pole in a magnetic field. And this is that path along which the north pole will move according to different positions. Next point is properties of magnetic lines of force or magnetic field lines. To make you understand, again we will take the help of same diagram. First point is, these lines of force, magnetic lines of force, are closed and continuous. Closed and continuous curves. This is very important point. These magnetic lines of force are closed and continuous. There is no break and they form complete loop. How? See, second point. They emerge from north pole of a magnet and merge at south pole of magnet that is outside the magnet they travel from north to south pole and inside the magnet they travel from south to north pole. See, now these two points. First point I said, magnetic lines of force are closed and continuous curve. Second point, the magnetic lines of force emerge from north pole and merge at south pole. That is, outside the magnet, they travel from north to south pole, as I told you earlier. They are traveling from north to south. And since they are, now I am coming back to this point, closed and continuous. There is no break, they are continuous. It is the picture of outside the magnet. Inside, these lines of force are traveling from south to north, and therefore they are forming complete loop, closed and continuous loop. So that outside they are traveling from north to south direction, and inside south to north. Just you see again, this is a magnet and this is the line of force. This is the line of force. So see the direction. Outside it is going north to south, and inside they are going to south to north. In the same way, another. This is closed and continuous curve. Inside they are traveling from south to north, and outside now north to south, and they are closed and continuous. So these two points I hope must be clear to you. Third point, and that is also very important, the relative strength of magnetic field, the relative strength of magnetic field is shown by the closeness of lines of force. What does it mean? It means, which I told you earlier, that as you are moving away from the magnet, its force on other body will go on decreasing. Means the strength of magnetic field as you are moving away from the magnet will go on decreasing. And this should be clearly visible in the magnetic field lines pattern drawn for a magnet. As I told you earlier also, that see this separation. Since these two lines are close to magnetic field, therefore relative strength is higher, but between these two the separation is much more. It shows that as you are going away from the magnet, the strength of magnetic field is going on decreasing. So that relative strength should be shown by the closeness of the magnetic lines of force. As you are moving away, the separation should keep on increasing. This is this point. The relative strength of magnetic field is shown by the closeness of lines of force. Next. Tangent drawn at any point of the magnetic field line
gives the direction of magnetic field at that point. Suppose we are interested in finding, since the curve is marked from north to south like this, suppose we are interested to find the magnetic field, direction of magnetic field at this point, then we will draw the tangent. Tangent means a line touching a curve at a particular point. So we will draw the tangent, and this will be the direction of magnetic field at this point. Last but not the least, very important point: two magnetic lines of force can never intersect each other. This is very important point, and you need to understand it. Two magnetic lines of force never intersect each other. I told you, magnetic field strength is a vector quantity. Vector quantity means it has magnitude as well as direction. And when we say direction, direction is fixed. A quantity will have fixed direction. So you can see in the diagram, no two lines of force are intersecting. Suppose intentionally you make the diagram like this, no, I will draw like this only. Now, what will happen? That you have shown in the diagram, suppose you have drawn like this, then you have shown this is north, this is south, so this is from north to south. Rest all the things are correct, but you have shown that two lines of force are intersecting each other. Then what will happen? See, at this point where the two lines of force are intersecting, that is at the point of intersection, if someone asks you what is the direction of magnetic field at this point, so since magnetic field is a vector quantity, it must have a fixed direction at that point, definite direction at that point, direction particular direction. Now, as I told you, that tangent drawn at any point gives the direction of magnetic field at that point. So now, since there are, at this point there are two curves, so we can draw two tangents, one along this and another along this. So there will be two directions of magnetic field, one is this, another is this, which is impossible. So very simple explanation of this point is, two lines of force can never intersect each other, because if they do so, then at the point of intersection there will be two directions of magnetic field, which is impossible. Therefore, two lines of force can never intersect each other. So this is all about the properties of magnetic lines of force. So till now, what we have learned: a current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet. Magnet has two important properties: attractive property and directive property. Attractive property means it attracts a magnetic material, and directive property, if it is suspended freely, it sets itself in the north-south direction. Third important property you are knowing, that's why I didn't discuss it, that like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other. Means there will be repulsion between north and north pole, there will be repulsion between south and south pole, there will be attraction between north and south pole of magnets. A magnet has a region around it in which its force can be experienced. That region or space is called magnetic field. The strength of magnetic field is the magnitude of magnetic field or the value of the magnetic field. Magnetic field is denoted by symbol B, capital letter, and its SI unit is Tesla. Since it has direction as well as magnitude, therefore it is a vector quantity. In a magnetic field, the path followed by the north pole or the path along which the north pole will travel in a magnetic field is called magnetic field lines. And magnetic field lines always travel from north to south pole outside a magnet and south to north pole inside the magnet. They are closed and continuous curve. Tangent at any point on the magnetic field line gives the direction of magnetic field. Two magnetic lines of force can never intersect each other. Then we have drawn the magnetic line field, magnetic lines of force of a bar magnet. You will show that the magnetic lines of force are traveling from north to south pole, and the relative distance between two magnetic lines of force will go on increasing if you move from first to second, second to third, third to fourth. Now here comes the assignment. In NCERT book of science, on page 224, question number 1, and on page number 228, 3 questions, 1, 2, 3, you need to solve. Now you are in a capacity to solve this question after going through this module carefully. I will meet you with the next module of the same chapter. Till then, stay safe, stay home. Thank you.